Hi, my name is Marissa. I am a sophomore studying chemistry and psychology. Those are both in our College of Liberal Arts and Sciences. And today I'm interviewing Professor Snodgrass. He's my professor for Atmospheric Sciences 120.
Right.
Severe and hazardous weather. Never said that out fully. We call it ATMS 120 on campus. And we're going to be asking him a couple of questions today.
Great. Well, I'm Eric Snodgrass. I'm the Director of Undergraduate Studies in Atmospheric Sciences. I'm also an academic advisor, and I get to teach this great class on campus along with several others in Atmospheric Sciences.
So you mentioned other classes. What else do you teach?
So I teach a variety all across all levels. My biggest classes would be the Severe and Hazardous Weather course, but I teach a 200-level course that's called General Physical Meteorology. It's a lot more math and physics-based treatment of atmospheric sciences. And then I teach some upper-level courses, one in instrumentation. I got a new course in development all about the economics of weather, and I advise some capstone students as well. And I teach one class in renewable alternative energy, which is entirely online, one of my favorites. So.
Wow. And how long have you been teaching here?
I started teaching in 2006, so I'm getting 11 years now. So.
And what's your favorite thing about teaching here?
You know, the caliber of the students is fantastic. And so what I enjoy is that I get a lot of back and forth with great students. They think well, and therefore my job is enjoyable because I get to teach people that are actually learning and they're listening and they're taking it in and doing something with it. And that makes it very rewarding. It's job satisfaction to see my students taking the stuff that I teach them and doing something with it.
Do we ever surprise you with anything?
All the time. The most recent assignment I gave you, where I asked you all to find your own examples of pseudoscience and then tell me what you found wrong with it, is I've been reading them now for like 8 hours, and they've been entertaining. They have been incredibly enlightening. So yes, I'm still very much surprised. Every new crop of students seems to get me surprised, though. So.